Hi guys, this is Fei Wu from Feisworld Media. I am so excited about not just this video, but a whole series of videos I'm bringing to you guys related to live streaming and also simulcasting or multi-streaming. So we all want to create content and then just drop it out there and reach as many people as possible, whether you're a dance or fitness instructor, or you're a content creator, coaches or speakers. I hope this series will really help you level up in your business. Today we're going to start with Castr. So I'm going to walk you through step by step from download all the way to connecting and how to hook it up with Zoom. Zoom makes it really, really interesting and simple as well. So after this part, after this video, there will be Restream and Loola coming up as well. I love this community. Thank you so much for sticking around and allowing me to talk about my favorite things, digital marketing and growing your business online. So much love, and I'll see you at the end of the video. Mwah. Now, you don't have to be a gamer. I am not one either. You could be a dance instructor, a coach, an artist, and you can still leverage simulcasting, which means that you can simultaneously broadcast to multiple platforms. Now, let's first take a look at this app called Castr. In the upcoming videos, I'll also be sharing with you other platforms such as Loola, as well as Restream. Those names are popping up all the time now. So I'm going to break down these apps in these intro videos one at a time, and then I'm going to compare all three apps and letting you know which one is right for your business. Well, let's get started. Now, for most of these platforms, you can sign up for a trial before you ever pull out your credit card, which is awesome. First, I'm going to enter my email, try it for free, and it's here for 7 days. The sign-up process is pretty straightforward. Give it a secure password and you're on your way. All right, once you create an account, you are in. You're greeted with, of course, some instructional messages right here, and it's going to walk you through and even showing you a video of how to get started. But since I don't need that, I'm going to exit out of it. So one benefit of Castr is once you create a stream, you can actually reuse it, as opposed to, can you imagine setting it up each and every time, especially if you're going to simulcast to multiple streams or platforms, you know, 5 or 10 of them. You certainly don't want to set up each and every one. Now, what we're going to do is new simulcast, which is simulcast to multiple sites. Now, one thing I want to explain, which is the way that Castr uses the word live stream is kind of confusing. They have a product called live stream, which is essentially the same as simulcast, with the exception of live streaming to website as opposed to your social media platform. So I'm going to start with new simulcast. First thing is, you do not have an active simulcast subscription. Would you like to activate our trial plan? The answer is yes. And now it's activated. You can name this stream. Again, it can be reused. I'm going to say that just call it Feisworld. Keep it simple. Of course, you could do, for example, your brand name on, but YouTube. For me, for example, Feisworld YouTube versus Feisworld Zoom, meaning where the feed is originated from. You can name it however you want. If you have multiple people sharing this account, you can even do one for Faye, one for Adam, one for Herman, doesn't matter. Now, the hosting region, what you want to do is select one that's closest to you. For me, it's New York, and you can save it. All right, it's walking through step by step, which is pretty cool. Next step is adding social media channel. Your stream will get recorded in the cloud, and you can preview and download your content, which is a really great feature, I think. Your stream event will get stored here as episodes, and you can download your content by clicking the VOD episode section. Castr Chat is integrated with Twitch, Mixer, and YouTube, and you can get chats and messages from these platforms all in one place. You can enable and disable the stream by clicking on this button. Lastly, you get your stream RTMP poll URL for pulling the stream to other services. I don't think you guys need to worry about that just yet. Start streaming right now. First thing first, I think we need to add some publishing platforms. Look at this, guys. I mean, how many are we talking about? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, 42 minus 3, that makes it 39 platforms. I think this gives us an excuse to try to be everywhere or in as many places as possible. So go ahead and definitely connect your platforms now. And also don't be intimidated by the number of options. Again, in the US, what you will find most popular, again, definitely Facebook Live, YouTube Live, Twitch, also Periscope. Where is it? Periscope is part of Twitter. Vimeo, a lot of people, especially filmmakers, are on Vimeo. And I don't see, probably because of my age and what I do, but I don't recognize many of the other ones. Livestream is one of the OGs in live streaming. So, you know, if you're starting with just 2-3 of them, it's absolutely fine. So I'm going to go ahead and connect Facebook Live. As you can see, you see these usual keys, usual buttons to set up. But what you can also do is, so set up with server and stream key as an alternative option. Castr will receive these things. I usually double check on everything else. Okay, that looks good. Post content to your timeline on your behalf, who can see it. You can start with friends if that makes you feel better, or you can do only me as a test. Hey guys, I mean, this option is great. You will have to come back and change it if, you know, beyond testing, just to make sure that you don't leave it as only me when you go live with your content. So I'm going to click on OK, just as a test. You can select the pages that you want to post this to. So I'm going to be very careful because I manage multiple accounts. So I want to make sure that only goes live on Feisworld Media. And same thing for pages. And I am going to allow only the pages I manage and just OK. Service connected successfully. You can now close this window. Here you can see the confirmation of the page you selected. For me, it's Feisworld Media. That's our company page, but also a group, a mastermind I manage. So it says right now it's only available from the broadcast times 2 plan, but the timeline one is available right away. And this is your stream description. This is the part that you do have to make relevant each and every time. Well, the rest of the settings are going to be relevant for the most part. Well, the rest of the setup is going to be very usable, but make sure that you modify the description. There's an option for you to toggle all of them on, but you can also select one at a time. All right, guys, as you can see, I connected 3, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch. They're pretty easy. They don't require you to enter keys or anything like that. It's kind of just ready to go. Now, I need to make sure that I have a webcam connected. So as soon as I do that, you see this pops up. I'm using Chrome browser. And it says a Castr IO wants to use your microphone, your camera. You need to hit allow. All right. Then from here, you may be wondering, how do I then use a familiar service and go live everywhere, especially if you're going to do interviews or group discussions and things like that, right? What you then can do is easily integrate Castr with Zoom. They make it pretty trivial. So what you need is, you will have a deployment region, so this link right here, as well as a streaming key. I'm not going to show that, but to find your streaming key, it's in this very location, and when you click on show, you'll get that. So now what you do is go back to Zoom, and this part is always a little bit confusing to me, so I'm going to show you guys where it appears to be. So it's under personal, and then settings, and then what you need to do is search for custom setting. You keep searching on this page, you will see something called custom live streaming service. You need to check that. Otherwise, all you have are these default ones. So check that and provide specific instructions that will enable meeting hosts in your account to configure live. What you do is, this is only a notes section, so it doesn't really do much, but you can leave your Castr. So I would, if I were you, I'll leave a note. It says Castr, and that will include both the deployment region code here as well as the streaming key in that note. This, by the way, is your own personal private information. You don't want to share it anywhere else. Okay, so after you do that, click on save. At least right now, I'm not putting anything in, but I know you know that I've just turned on custom live streaming service for my Zoom. Now what I need to do is come back to Zoom. I'll log myself in, and I will start a meeting just like this, okay? Now you go see here, more, under more, you can click on live on custom streaming services. Click on that. Once you do that, I'm getting this page right here where it asks you streaming URL, streaming key, and live streaming page URL. Streaming URL is the link RTMP below your deployment region. And then your streaming key is what's hidden here. Now, I found this information off of Zoom. If you search for live streaming page URL Zoom, it's going to take you to this page. So essentially, if you are someone who isn't necessarily using a simulcasting service, then you could potentially broadcast your live stream through a single page URL, such as a YouTube link. And to do this, this page actually walks you through how to go live on YouTube and how you're able to integrate that through a new stream. But for the purpose of Castr, you can leave live streaming page URL empty and entering only these two fields. Once that's connected, again, it's gonna push live based on the number of social service accounts and platforms that you have indicated here. And one thing to know that if you first set it up as a test for yourself, for example, like what I just did for Facebook Live, I only allow myself to see the stream. You are unable to make further changes once it's kind of dropped in here. So you can see that once I click on the gear button, it says platform is connected, live account cannot be edited, but can be toggled or deleted. So either you change the name here, this is, you can say Fei Wu, only me, and then you can connect another one, reconnect Facebook Live, and that one could be everyone, you know, public or friends only, so you can modify it from there. All right, I just confirmed using a documentation, which I'll be including in the description below, that shows and confirms that the Castr livestream page URL currently will not work with Zoom. Again, what you need to do is simply confirm the stream URL and key, that's it. So I hope you guys found this video helpful, in particular how to connect Castr with Zoom, which is an app that you already are familiar with. Definitely an experiment. Remember that you can toggle these things on and off, and you can privately share on your Facebook page if you want. And a better idea, in case you get super nervous, is simply to create a test account. Maybe that's a test page account or a test Facebook group page or Facebook page account. So nobody will, you know, find you that way, and you can keep the group as private as you wish. So experiment and have some fun and live stream away. You are now officially a streamer. So you may be wondering, who exactly is using Castr right now? What does the result look like? So instead of talking about me only, I want to introduce you to my friend Esprit Devora. This is her using Castr to go live on Twitter/Periscope. She also went live on Facebook and a few other places. So as you can see, this is a replay from her going live from Castr on May 1st. And the video is always muted when you first scroll to this position, and you can turn it up.
If there is one resource for podcasting, period, but unfortunately it's only available to women, it's the She Podcast Facebook group.
All right, so check it out. You know, she went live with her group of friends from Zoom directly. Her setup is exactly the same. In fact, Esprit was the person who introduced me to Castr in the first place. So I definitely want to give her a shout out, not just her brand, but also her amazing podcast called Women in Tech. So definitely check it out. I'll include it in the description below. And as you can see, they're just such an opportunity for you to go live, you know, directly to so many different channels. And these replays are available on these channels as well. So keep in mind that even if people don't discover you right away when you are live, they're going to be people stumbling upon your content and they feel that they're involved. You know, everybody's very familiar with Zoom, and that's why I want to do this special video so you guys don't have to worry about learning another tool such as OBS and all that jazz. Welcome to the club. If you find these videos helpful, please let me know, share with your friends, leave your questions below, and let me know what else you would like to see. And give us a thumbs up. Last but not least, hit subscribe. That makes a huge difference, and I'll deliver all the yummy, delicious new content right to your inbox. See you next time.